around the world as the leader in sports television.
She married the man of her dreams, but he could be her worst nightmare.
People who killed him are after me.
Susan Lucci in The Bride in Black. Then on the commission, security guard turns vigilante.
You got that much contempt for the law. You shoot a man in cold blood.
And Tony takes him down on an all-new commish after The Bride in Black here on ABC tonight.
Hey, congratulations.
Isn't this your first?
It's my second.
You must be very proud.
Oh, I am.
Dunkin' Donuts is happy to announce a new arrival. Introducing Dunkin' Dot Roast Coffee. It has a bolder, more intense flavor. We roast the beans longer than we do for our regular coffee, so you get a unique, robust taste of a dot roast coffee.
I love them equally. They each have their own special quality.
New Dunkin' Dot Roast, another world-famous coffee from Dunkin' Donuts.
I've been sleeping on a waterbed for about 20 years.
I feel 100% better on my waterbed.
Quality of sleep is really important to me.
Having a waterbed is a very good, long-term, wise investment in your health.
I love my waterbed.
I have to have my waterbed.
I just simply won't sleep on anything else. Can't do it.
Time to wake up to a great night's sleep.
Off-track betting, the lowest prices every night.
Walter Cronk,
Karen Adams,
Channel 12 Eyewitness News.
The following is a special presentation of ABC Sports.
Gentlemen, we proudly present the five finalists for this afternoon's Long Island Open. Fifth-seeded Bill Oakes of Lawton, Oklahoma, is looking for his first PBA championship. His opponent, Steve Wilson, also a non-winner but making his second appearance in our finals this year. Third-seeded Nelson Burton Jr. has appeared on all of this year's telecasts, but behind the microphone, Bo's a 17-time PBA champion and a member of the PBA Hall of Fame. Next up is Del Ballard Jr., the two-time winner of the Long Island Open and now a member, will be, of the PBA's Millionaires Club. And our tournament leader is Amleto Monacelli of Venezuela, a two-time PBA Player of the Year and 13-time PBA champion. That's our field for this afternoon's Professional Bowlers Tour telecast. Yes, Rep. Slayville, New York, on beautiful Long Island for the finals of the $140,000 Long Island Open. And what a great place it is, Long Island, 118 miles in length. And even when it's snow-covered, it's great. Our tournament's going to be fantastic, too, because for the first time in 10 years, my colleague is not up in the booth with me, but he's a star. We brought in the 1994 star of all of bowling, Johnny Petraglia, to take his place. Johnny, welcome.
Thanks, Chris, and it's really great bringing up here. Chris, the story today is comeback. Bill Oakes averaging 246 the last four games to make TV. Steve Wilson averaged 260 the last eight games to make TV. Del Ballard in the number two spot in the worst slump of his career, trying to win three out of four in this bowling alley that he loves. And the leader, Amleto Monacelli, winless in 1993, has come back to take the lead here. And the biggest comeback of all, 51-year-old Nelson Burton Jr., showing us that he's still a threat. And I think we're going to see him bowl when he won the St. Louis Open 10 years ago, when he shot 1050 and broke that record. And the only thing that's changed is he's got a little bit more gray hair, and he's about 10 pounds heavier, but the classic style is still there. And here he is live, down to my buddy Bo.
Well, thank you, John. Like a fine wine, I hope I get a little bit better, but
I know how tough it is in the announcement. If I have a bad day down here, I'm out of here in 20 minutes. You guys have a bad day, you still got to struggle for 90 minutes. So good luck, guys. I'll give it my best. And Chris, take it away.
Thank you. $140,000, and Bo wants that $24,000. I know he just loves that green stuff. $13,000 for second, $8,500 third, $6,000 for fourth, and $5,000 for the person that loses this first game. And the first match is between Steve Wilson, a non-winner, and Bill Oakes, his opposition here today, also is looking for his first national PBA title. And Wilson, very attractive young man, 25 years old. He was third at this year's AC Delco Classic. Here's the first shot, finals of the Long Island Open.
Great shot right away, Chris, by Steve Wilson. It's 25-year-old. He can really throw the ball. He's got that quick wrist at the bottom. It's just terrific.
Now we look at 37-year-old Bill Oakes of Lawton, Oklahoma. Sporting a beard of a few weeks. Little change. Well, Johnny, you can tell us how to cover those pins.
Well, Bill Oakes is a lock and load kind of guy. What I mean by that is he likes to throw the ball pretty hard. And if he's over-pumped in the first couple of frames, he'll increase the speed a little too much and hit light, is what happened on that shot.
Johnny Petraglia, my commentator buddy today, Triple Crown champion along with Billy Hardwick and Pete Weber, now hoping for a spare.
Great spare, isn't it?
Steve Wilson in his second telecast of this
now,
year.
Now here he is, Chris, letting it go. He's got to hit the left side of that two pin, which he does, and the ball takes out the back pin. He covers it perfectly. Great shot by Bill Oakes.
Here's Bill taking care of that almost a University of Texas orange.
Okay, now here's Billy standing on about five. He's going to slide on five and go right down the first arrow.
Didn't come up, did it?
No, Chris, he left the 1-2-8. He was striking a lot in practice, but I think he's a little bit nervous. See, he loses it a little bit at the bottom. He doesn't catch it all with the fingers. That causes the ball to slide and stay out around those boards that aren't really flipping back until they get to the middle of the lane where he wants to be.
In match play, Bill won half of the matches, 12 and 12.
Okay. I think he's fine now, Chris.
All right. And now, Steve Wilson, as we indicated, third in the AC Delco Classic, which was our first event of the year. Fourth year that we've been here at the Leisure Centers, the Savo Bowl.
So a double puts a little pressure on John.
Chris, he's picking up right where he left off. Watch this fast wrist at the bottom that he has, Chris. As he lets that ball go, his hand holds its position all the way, and then right here, it moves really fast. That's where he gets all that snap in the back end, and he bowled like that all night last night. Just great.
You're listening to the resonant tones of my sidekick today, Johnny Petraglia, because Nelson Burton Jr. is in the number three seed and will meet the winner of this first game. He loves this pair, obviously.
That's very important, nice and early, Chris. You want to jump out to that early lead before you go to that first commercial break, and that puts a lot of pressure on Bill Oakes right now to try and throw a double to stay right in the match real early.
Mm-hmm. First, it didn't come up, and that one came up too high.
He overcompensated, Chris, leaving the big four. What happened is he got a little bit soft, and that ball started grabbing soon. It happens, I guess, commonly on TV where you adjust off a bad shot, which Bill Oakes did right there.
What do we do here, punt?
We go for the two, probably the fourth, Devin, and try to bounce him out of the pit.
Okay.
Almost.
Bill Oakes' last two championship round opponents averaged, get this, 284 against him, but that's not a major concern today.
there's not a whole lot of remedy you can do for your, what your opponent's bowl, so I'm going to go out and try to shoot 269 like I did last time, and I feel like if I shoot that today, I should win the title.
After an open.
All right. Great shot, Bill.
Yes. We're in Sayville, New York, located on the south shore of Long Island, which you may or may not know is the home to the very interesting, and visit it next time, the Maritime Museum.
When your dentist cleans your teeth, he uses special instruments that get between them. But what toothbrush would your dentist prefer to use? Well, in a recent nationwide test, dentists tried a leading flat brush and Crest Complete. The brush more dentists preferred was Crest Complete. See, Crest Complete is shaped like your teeth, so it reaches far between them. Now, shouldn't you choose Crest Complete? Of course you should. And it's now available in designer black.
All right, Chief, open wide. Come on. Look, Daddy loves corn pops, see? And here he comes.
The problem with a cereal that tastes like popcorn, only sweeter, is that it disappears like popcorn, only faster.
Y'all finish? Good boy!
He may want seconds.
Kellogg's corn pops. It's hard to stop when it's pops.
We're nearing the halfway point of our first game here in the Long Island Open. Standing room only crowd. And you want to know something? A ticket to this live telecast and the four matches, $50. 5-0.
All right.
Oh, boy, you see one
four-bagger, John.
Chris, he's really lined up. We may see a 300 today. He's nice and loose, just like he was last night. He's playing that first arrow with just a little bit of an arc to it, and he's getting the perfect entry angle into the pocket to carry.
Okay. So now he'll move over to the left side. Here's a man that qualified 24th and then moved up, was 16th going into last night. Sherry Holden, his fiance, is here. Oh, yeah. Bill Oakes has, he picks the Tigers as opponents. Of course, he doesn't pick them.
Oh, what a terrible break. A solid 4-9. That was a real good shot. Okay. Now, here's Bill Oakes' style. If you watch from the back, you'll see that Oakes' swing comes straight back or a little bit out. That makes him go down and in and as where he likes to play, and the ball jumped a little bit on him to leave a 4-9.
So it's his second open frame of this very first match. And it causes Steve Wilson to jump out to a 71-10 lead.
Well, I have a little history on this, Chris. If he doesn't do much, Steve can start thinking about 300, knowing that he has the match well in hand.
All right,
I think he's lost, Chris, a little bit. He's a little soft, and it hooks high on him, a little quick, and it's sliding on him, and Billy's starting to reach that point in the game where did I leave it in the back?
He's really disappointed at this point.
Oh, he's such a tough competitor, Chris. You're never going to have him out of the wood because he can strike out at any time.
All right, we're in the sixth frame. Five in a row. Right lane. High. Leaving a 3-6. But this crowd here on Long Island appreciates the five in a row.
Right. He really jumped on this one, Chris. You could see it at the bottom as his wrist curled in, it causing the ball to hook early through the nose and leaving the 3-6. Had his feet a little bit fast.
Okay. Steve Wilson is only 25 years old, and if he gets past Bill Oakes, his opponent, Bo Burton, would be twice his age. So will Steve prepare differently?
No, I'm not going to approach it any differently. As you know, there's no defense in bowling. I'm just going to go out there and attack the pins, try and knock down as many as I can, and hopefully my score is a little better than his when I get back.
Steve Wilson from Fort Lauderdale, Florida.
Now, the important thing right here, Chris, is he's in the position with four frames to go that he's probably going to win this game. You have to make sure you don't get an adrenaline drain and that you have to stay up for the next match because you're bowling a superstar game coming up. And he's not going to give it to you easy.
Mm-hmm. Well, immediately looked at his hand, which formed the grip. The Sago Long Island area, where we are today, is noted for its oyster harvesting. And the Oyster House, which is part of the Maritime Museum, has several oyster industry-related exhibits on display.
Have any Bud Light in your vehicle?
Yes.
And I am Mr. Gally Weekich.
You mean Dr. Galakowicz?
Yes, I am. This is so cool.
First time in a limo, Doctor?
In a limo this small.
If you want great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light. Spitfire earned a United States patent. Spitfire doesn't look like any other spark plug. And the patented Spitfire doesn't work like any other spark plug. 5 extra horsepower by merely installing these plugs. Quicker in the quarter mile. A 4.8% gain in mileage. There's nothing like a Spitfire. You'll get more power and more mileage. Or your money back. Get the guaranteed Spitfire advantage at leading automotive stores from coast to coast.
Christy Yamaguchi headlines the field at the Durasoft Colors World Challenge of Champions. Plus Olympic champ Tony Moe soars again next on ABC's Wide World of Sports.
Okay, Chris, here's the reason that Steve misses that 10 pin. As he lets it down, it slides right off his hand, so it doesn't grab on the lane, causing it to slide into the gutter. And now he'll take a look at his thumb, which is the natural reaction to see if you left something on there that shouldn't.
Wish we could do that when we speak. But once you say it, you can't take it back, you know.
Boy, don't I know that.
Bill Oakes, Lawton, Oklahoma. No. Okay, now we turn the tables. 9-time champion Randy Peterson with a guest.
Thanks, Chris. You know, Bud, winning never gets old, and apparently you don't either. You pulled great this week. Congratulations. Any plans with that? All that money you're going to make today?
Well, I don't know how much I'm going to make. It's $24,000 for first. I'd like to get it. If I get that much, I'm going to give it to Johnny Petraglia to pay his taxes and all that money he's making this year.
That's great, but thanks.
Don't you believe it, Johnny. Beautiful, beautiful double.
Bill Oakes with two great shots doing just what he had to do. It looked like it was over.
Steve Wilson makes a mistake. Bill Oakes, possible 209. Wilson's going to have to mark two of the last three frames to lock it up.
All right. Tonight, Susan Lucci stars in the ABC Saturday night movie, The Bride in Black, followed by an all-new episode of The Commish. Yes, that's all tonight here on ABC.
Steve, he's going to walk a fairly straight line.
Nice frame.
Well, Chris, that really locked it up for Steve Wilson. He's going to just breeze into this game, and he just has to mentally stay sharp going into the next game against Bo.
And we hope Bill Oakes can strike out. Oh, another 4-9. He smiles.
Second 4-9 of the day for Bill Oakes. When it rains, it pours. Usually it means you have a little too much angle to the pocket, Chris, or the ball's in a little bit too hard, one or the other. Either way, it's unlucky.
Here's a good time to praise a bowler's family, Patty and Lauren and Nicholas. Bill couldn't stay out here if it weren't for the cooperation from his family. You know, he's out here all the time, and today, he's going to make about $5,000. That's pretty good. There's a man that will go next against Nelson Burton Jr.
It was a great performance by Bill Oakes this week. He averaged only 202 those first four games last night and dropped out of the top five, losing them all, and really came back strong, averaging 246 and winning all of them.
And to come all the way from 24th to the fifth seed, and that's where he's going to finish and pick up a check for $5,000. We congratulate this 37-year-old. He often calls himself an Army brat because his father was a sergeant major, and they lived in a lot of different countries and cities. Loves Germany.
Good.
This ABC Sports presentation of the Professional Bowler Tour will continue after these messages and a word from our ABC stations.
My wife asked me for a diamond. So naturally, I went to True Value, where the guy got me the right brush, roller, all the right stuff. He even kidded me. Paint it and he will come. Will he ever face a big league hitter? Who knows? Judging from the drool on his chin, I'd be waiting on the spitball.
For your free 101 Painting Tips booklet, visit your local participating True Value.
Okay, two scoops of raisins make Kellogg's Raisin Bran taste so good, people forget it's good for you. What do you think?
It's delicious.
And?
It tastes good.
That's the same reason.
He stole my answer.
It's not an answer.
I agree with them. It tastes great.
Okay. You got the first part right. Kellogg's Raisin Bran tastes good, but...
good for us!
There are two reasons to eat Kellogg's Raisin Bran. The taste.
And...
I'm an excellent driver.
Yeah, that's good. Come on.
Who is this guy?
Raymond is your brother.
Winner of four Academy Awards.
Uh-oh.
Including Best Picture.
What's the name of what?
Rayman, Sunday at 8, 7 Central.
Have you seen the fine print in these health club ads? Unbelievable. New England Health and Racket, different story. 5 weeks, $50, period. No restrictions. Shape up with swimming, aerobics, Nautilus, free weights, basketball, racquetball, 7 days a week. Oh, you can bring your kids. $50 total. That's fine.
Get 5 weeks for only $50.
New England Health and Racket. The shape of things to come.
Harold's is having an office furniture expo, and everything is on sale. You'll save an additional 10% off our everyday low prices on home, office, and executive office furniture. Harold's has desks, credenzas, bookcases, file storage, and computer furniture in every style and finish for today's office. If you want to save up to 60% on all office furniture, come to Harold's, your office furniture specialist.
Ann Conway, Channel 12, Eyewitness News.
The Pro Bowlers Tour, brought to you by Bud Light. If you want great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light. Kellogg's, with good taste, nutrition, and value. The best to you each morning from Kellogg's. And Crest Complete Toothbrush. Crest Complete helps maintain a dentist clean.
Yes, our first game has ended in the Long Island Open. And Steve Wilson from Fort Lauderdale, Florida, with 10 strikes, defeated Bill Oakes 256 to 173. And now, Johnny Petraglia. Nelson Burton Jr. in the white shirt. First time in 10 years And we get an opportunity to take shots at him. He's been taking shots at everybody.
Oh, no, I got 10 frames to get even, Chris.
Haven't we? But first, Steve Wilson, 10 strikes. I was going to watch with all of us. Why?
Chris, perfect shot. Solid eighth. There's nothing you can do about it. The only legal rep in bowling. One thing's for sure, whether he's bowling bow or not, he's not shaking.
First game, 256 to Bill Oaks 173. Now, here he is. Pride and joy of St. Louis. It's Nelson Burton Jr. Four pin.
Real good first shot, Chris, after 10 years. Now, here's Bo's classic style. You'll see that the shoulders keep dropping down. Body position perfect. Watch the knee and the follow through, and when Bo lets the ball go, there's the plumb line right here, nice and straight, everything where it should be.
And you know, Johnny, the great person that preceded Bo is my color commentator, Billy Whalo, used to always talk about tripping the four pin, you know.
Tripping the four pin. There are people that do it well, and there are people that don't, and there's really not much you can do about it, Chris. It's the way that your ball rolls and enters the pocket. Now here's Bo. He's going to slide around five and walk fairly straight, and his swing will also be fairly straight. That's why he likes to play outside and go up the boards. He'll come right up the gutter right here.
There you are. Powerful, powerful strike. 51 years old and looks 30. Former wrestler, weightlifter, bench presses 252.
He's a good cook, too.
Can he cook?
He can cook. He cooks pasta.
Strongly. On the right lane was Steve Wilson of Fort Lauderdale.
Wilson, he's really lined up, Chris, sorry. He hasn't really made any mistakes yet except that one ball on the first five that went through the nose. Other than that, everything else has been solid pocket.
Remember, this is only his second telecast ever. For Bo, it's his 48th.
Here's Steve's grip. He uses the conventional fingertip grip, curls that pinky. And that gives you a little bit more turn at the bottom.
All right. Beautiful. Bo's last strike was a thing to behold. Let's see if he can repeat it.
See, now, Bo uses the same fingertip grip, but he's not going to curl his pinky. He leaves it out. He likes to stay behind the ball and get the ball up the lane.
High hit and another four.
Little tight again, Chris. In practice, he leaked a couple of balls that hung, and now he's pushing it up the lane, and it hits high and leaves the four pin. Actually, he caught a break, not getting a split on this particular shot.
All right, Nelson Burton Jr. continuing to mark. First time in the telecast since 1984. And we have with us today the Triple Crown champion, Johnny Petraglia, who's going to watch with me tomorrow, beginning at 2 Eastern, 1 Central Pacific, here on ABC. Top IndyCar drivers head down under for their first event of the year, the Valvoline Australian Grand Prix. Then, in Key Biscayne, Pete Sampras meets Andre Agassi in the men's final of the Lipton Championships, all tomorrow here on ABC.
State history. It's Quaker State's new advanced high-tech formula motor oil. It gives your engine superior protection against wear. Superior protection against heat and stress. Superior cleaning power. Protect your car's engine with new advanced Quaker State Motor Oil. It's formulated for today's high-tech engines.
This is a new car. I'd be crazy not to use Quaker State.
Chili, fried coffee.
Better add on some tums.
On the house.
Except these aren't tums.
Same thing.
Got them all mixed up.
I told you, they're all the same.
Listen to me. Tums has calcium. Is this calcium? No. It uses aluminum and magnesium. So does this. The only one of these that helps wipe out heartburn and gives you calcium you need is Tums.
Something my body needs anyway. I like that.
Tums. Insist on calcium-rich Tums.
See if you can stomach this. Bowling's best. Roll into Connecticut. Trying to avoid heartburn and heartburn. It's the Tums Classic next week on ABC's Pro Bowlers Tour.
The defending champion of the Tums Classic, Jason Couch. He'll be there. And here today is Steve Wilson, who won the first game 256 to Billy Oaks, 173. Now going against Nelson Burton Jr. And he takes a 20-10 lead and down to the mop man, Randy Peterson.
Thanks, Chris. Del, your girlfriend, Carolyn Dorwin, won a tournament earlier this year. Now, so far, she's the leading money winner in the family. Are you going to change that today?
I've got to. You know, she's been the breadwinner all year long, so this is my duty. And maybe there'll be a surprise if I win.
Best of luck, Del. Back to you guys.
Well, Del has won two championships right here. Well, he has no mercy.
First, no mercy today. Steve Wilson is really sharp. That trip four the previous frame was really a great break. It gave him a 20-pin lead and got him loose. Bo's got to perform right here. This is when he throws him for the butter, he throws him good. I'm expecting a good shot right now.
Rooting back in St. Louis, Katrina, Nikki, Nelson, and Brett. His four children, and of course his mom and dad.
Now, Chris, he's a little bit confused on the right-hand lane here in the fact that the ball's hooking a little bit early on him, and he's trying to force it into the pocket. Here's Bo right here. Everything looks good, but as he gets right here, you'll see the elbow come just a little bit out and up toward the head pin. He doesn't want to trust it on that lane like he is on 49.
Oh, yes. Bo turned away in despair. Made a 180, and let's replay it.
Here's the replay, Cliff. He chops the 6 off the 10 clean, but the pin knows he's a veteran and it knocks it back out of the pit to make the spin.
Well, now, Nelson Burton Jr., there's another reason why he's in the PBA and the American Bowling Congress Halls of Fame. What a guy. 17-time PBA champion, player of the year in 1970. Oh, yes.
Great shot there, Chris. Chris, the big threat about Bo is if he can get by this game, he'll bowl great the next game. The second game on a pair is when he's his toughest, and there's a lot of game left.
Okay, and with four in a row, shooting in the sixth frame, Steve Wilson.
Steve Wilson just performing magnificently. No mistakes last night, no mistakes today. Just terrific.
The defending champion, Dave Arnold, finished 23rd, and we indicated that Del Ballard won the first two Long Island Opens. This is our fourth time at Save-O Bowl, and we always look forward to it. Johnny?
Oh, it's always wonderful being here. Mr. Colacci and Save-O people are just wonderful.
And this game can bring you down to earth.
Okay. Now, to make this split, Chris, he's going to have to hit the left side of the four pin right about here. Just took the pin.
We look at Bo. He's trailing by 24. There's a bowling news update fact. We'll return.
I know it's a kid's cereal, but I love Kellogg's Frosted Flakes. This is my story.
I used to go to secluded places so no one would discover me. I knew it was wrong, but I just couldn't help myself. That's when it happened.
Hey, what's going on in there? On in there.
Luckily, he understood.
How can I condemn a man for something I do myself?
You've got to admit, Frosted Flakes have a taste adults have grown to love. They're great.
Bowling is some people's idea of fun. Now, truck bowling, that's when things can get real interesting. But to do it right, you gotta have one of these. A 1994 Ford Ranger 4x4. Complete with push-button four-wheel drive, a whopping 4-liter V6, and a wide, powerful stance. Get a Ford Ranger 4x4 and go truck bowling. Come on. I just love league nights.
1993 was one of the biggest years in box office history. Now, the movies are put to the ultimate test. Oscar night, live Monday.
From Venezuela, our tournament leader, twice player of the year, Amleto Monicelli.
Well, Chris, 8 years in the Army, 59 to 67. It's time to dig down and remember what you did then. Get your head in it. That's so he knows, see that red line? That's so he knows what foot to start with, huh?
Oh, yes. Of course, he started with a great teacher, his Hall of Fame dad, Nelson Burton, Sr. And he's taken it from there.
A tremendously important shot, Chris. He hit his tough lane, number one. If he can throw this one here, he gets the game less than 10 pins. We have a whole new ball game. Here, let's watch.
And watching him shoot 10-50 in 1984 with games at 278, 279, 257, 236, he can do anything. And you know, Johnny, each week up here, I kid him about the scouts. I'm a big scout man.
They call that slamming the dime, Chris. He got about 8 cents. What a shame. He throws a real good shot. See, no crack in the elbow that time. He trusts it really well. Swishes the five into the left wall. Headpin comes back and hits the 10, but not hard enough to take it out.
Right there, he gave a tip of the week, an extra bonus. Take your time on spares. Get set, do it properly, right?
That's it. Steve Wilson really has to dig down here. He's got a 17-pin lead with 3 frames to go. He still has a lot of work to do. Okay, Chris, I'm going to set up what's going to happen here for the rest of the game. If Steve Wilson makes this spare and goes strike spare out, it's 226. Nelson has a possible 229. So, depending on what Nelson does, Steve Wilson must first of all mark right here, and then just for protection has to get a strike or a spare in the ninth frame.
Okay, coming up next on ABC's Wide World of Sports, 1992 Olympic gold medalist Christy Yamaguchi and longtime rival Midori Ito headlined the ladies' competition from the Durasoft Colors World Challenge of Champions, plus Olympic gold medalist Tommy Moe in World Cup downhill skiing, all here next on ABC Sports.
Well, he struck, Chris. Bo gets up. If Bo throws a double, he will force Steve Wilson to mark in the 10th. If Bo throws 3 strikes, he'll force Steve Wilson to strike in the 10th. Let's watch. You don't get 17 titles by not performing when you have to. He's the best at it.
Pesky 10 again.
Chris, there's nothing you can do about it. His form, you know, look at the floor, not at the score, hold your form together, everything that you're taught when you're learning to bowl, he did on that shot. Solid 10. Put it where he had to.
You know, this year, Bo had a ninth place finish in the Choice Hotels event.
He keeps getting younger every week. Mm-hmm. Here's the situation, Chris. If he doubles in the 10th frame, he'll force Steve Wilson to mark.
Okay.
If he doesn't, Steve will just have to keep it on the lane.
And the pinfall you hear here at Sable Bowl is the practicing shots of Amleto Monacelli. Winner will meet Del Ballard, J.R. Meanwhile, another J.R., Nelson Burke. United States Open.
Chris, that's as good as it gets right there. Yep. Solid as a rock. Eyes on your target all the way.
You can imagine the anxiety in St. Louis with his dad, Nelson Burton Jr., and his mom and kids.
The four kids.
Mm-hmm.
Tripper and Brett. Trina and Nikki. I'm sure they'll watch him with bated breath. For the butter, Chris. Best shot of the game.
Mm-hmm.
Kept that elbow in all the way. Followed through right toward his target. When you hit high flush, they always go down.
And imagine, this young man wasn't even born when we started this series 33 years ago. He's 25. Here's a man that was 18 when we started the series in 1962. My heavens. This is a very proud athlete from St. Louis.
Great performance by Bowles. He really threw him good when he had to. But here's a real tough kid. He's done everything he's been asked to do for the last 10 games. We'll see how he performs in the 10th. Needs a spare plus three pins to win.
That's the way to take care of it.
He threw it great, Chris. The kids coming up, they're so well practiced, and they're so good now. They get on TV, they don't shake at all. He threw that as good as if he's been out there 20 years.
I think we're getting a lot of good players from Florida.
Well, Florida, all of a sudden, it's really come on.
Mm-hmm.
They come off the golf course into the lanes and kill us.
Bob Espy. Someday you'll learn it's a difficult game.
Yeah, great performance by Steve Wilson.
It really is. Big 218 for that man. We're proud of him. To go along with a 256. This week, Choice Hotel's Tip of the Week features another Triple Crown winner, Billy Hardwick.
ABC Sports presents a winning never gets old bowling tip. Brought to you by Quality, Comfort, Clarion, and Sleep Hotels.
Our guest today is Triple Crown winner and Hall of Famer, Billy Hardwick. Billy, watching that fellow in the shot there with all that hair, is that really you?
I like the hair, Bill. I think I'm going to bring it back.
Well, Bill, when I first met you some 30 years ago, you started with these two fingers in the bowling ball, and then you went to these two fingers, and you had success both ways. Does it really make any difference?
Well, when you're young, nothing makes a difference. Everything works, and you believe in it. But as you get older, you have to get smarter. You have to become more precise. What I've had to do is knock a pound to a pound and a half off the weight of the ball, and shorten the span so that I can still stay in charge of my game. So a shorter span, lighter ball, your career can go on forever.
For you seniors, take a tip from a great one, Billy Hardwick. Shorten that span so you have more control, lighten that ball, and you can extend your career. And remember, winning never gets old.
Look for future ABC Sports Winning Never Gets Old bowling tips. Brought to you by Quality, Comfort, Clarion, and Sleep Hotels.
There are gut balls and gutter balls, and sometimes the trophy falls. But no matter what, you'll love the bowlers who have it all on ABC Sports home video, Bowling the Perfect Game. Call 1-800-4-ABC-VCR to order Bowling's colorful history, narrated by Chris Schenkel and Nelson Burton Jr. This collector's home video can be yours to enjoy for only $14.98 plus $3.95 shipping. That's 1-800-4-ABC-VCR.
You know, winning never gets old, and neither does saving money. If you're 50 or over, just call 1-800-4-CHOICE to reserve a room in any Quality, Comfort, Clarion, or Sleep hotel. And you can save 30% off the price of your room. That number again, 1-800-4-CHOICE. Perfect.
Travelers 50 and over save 30% at Quality, Comfort, Clarion, and Sleep hotel.
It's never fun to eat and run, to rush and eat too fast, cause you know it's gonna catch up with you at last.
For acid indigestion or heartburn with headache, nothing's faster than Alka-Seltzer.
Get yourself some Alka-Seltzer and you'll feel better fast.
NAPA, we're the most complete source for auto parts, and all NAPA parts are backed by a nationwide warranty program. No wonder more Americans trust NAPA to keep their vehicles running.
Keep America running.
Non-winner Steve Wilson, 256, 10 strikes. In the second game against our colleague Nelson Burton Jr., 9 strikes, 246 to 218. As we look at Mark Colacci and Bill Parks, vice presidents of the Leisure Bowling Centers, and very competent, able vice presidents.
Okay, the size of the field this week, 173 players. The overall average was 211 and a 224 average to make the top 24. And the top finishers, Ed Richardson finishing sixth in a great game, 2 7-10s cost him the show. Don Moser, Brian LeClaire, Butch Soper, a stat man this week. Jeff Lizzie, David Traber, the national champion. And then we have Hall of Famer, Wayne Webb. Ray Shackle wanted me to get his name right, and I think I got it wrong. The Quaker State champion, Steve Hoskin. David Carter, Dave Arnold, defending champion. Tom Baker for the old guys round out the top 24.
And of course, our next 2 weeks, here's where we'll be for the Tums Classic, Windsor Locks, Connecticut. It'd be nice to get back and see all our friends there. It'd be a great event. And then, unique, Splitfire Spark Plug Open. It's going to be staged the finals at the Eric Civic Center. The Warrens have it all prepared, and we look forward to having 4 lanes especially set up, Johnny, for that event, the final.
Oh, I can't wait, Chris.
Here he is, the man that won twice here at the Sabo Bowl. Leaving a 10, the man that takes no time.
A great first shot there, Chris. Everything was perfect, ring and 10. He just loves this house. I'm glad to see him bowling well again. He struggled so much earlier in the year that he's really come around. And the main reason was he changed the weights in his bowling balls. Gone to different weights, and it's worked perfectly this week.
Got it. All right. Best finish this year was 10th in the AC Delco Classic. And here's the man with his great finish here. 2 victories already this afternoon. 25-year-old Steve Wilson of Fort Lauderdale.
Same way you started last game, Chris. Solid 8, except that was on 49. This one's on 50. Okay. And there's nothing much you can do about this. Perfect shot, right out between the first and second arrow. When the ball hits high flush, chops the 5 right off the 8 for a solid 8. Perfect shot.
$50 a ticket to watch the finals and the Long Island Open at Sabo Bowl.
Well, they got a strong cast to watch here, Chris. I think the show is well worth.
Our last game was interesting to watch as this man defeated Nelson Burton Jr. 246 to 218, but Bowl bowled a powerful game.
Solid 4, Chris. A real good shot. You can critique it a little bit and say he got on it just a shade, but he hasn't missed the pocket but twice. Now as he lets it go, he gets a little bit more than normally, so the ball is jumping right at the very end, a little bit high flush for a solid 4. it hooked a little bit harder in the back end than the previous shot on that lane because he lifted harder than normal.
Now, look at the man from Richardson, Texas, Del Ballot Jr. He marked with a spare second frame.
Love out on the lane and a strike.
Now, Chris, we showed Burton before, and here's Ballard the same way. That perfect line to the line, and then as he lets it go, those perfect knees and that plumb line just where it should be, right there. Shots on that left lane, Chris, and two ringing tens. Where those eyebrows start wrinkling. You know, he calls me Grandpa, and I call him Deputy Dog, and then I found out half of the tour doesn't even remember Deputy Dog.
Well, of course, Dell only needs one more major PBA National Championship to join you, Johnny. Billy Hardwick and Pete Weber as Triple Crown winners.
I know, and I know he wants it badly. The type of player that will be there. He'll be around a long time.
Here's a man fighting for that first PBA national victory. He has 8 regionals.
Chris, Steve Wilson is having the kind of a day that if I take, I would say, 4 shots and took them out, that everything else will look like an instant replay. His repetition and his shot making today is as good as it gets.
Oh, he had 19 strikes coming into this, his third game.
Now watch on this overhead shot. Steve will walk basically straight, a couple of boards to his left. He'll end up right about in this area. His swing ends up right behind his right hip, and he'll arc out over fire.
Steve Wilson leads Del Ballard by 9. We'll return to Long Island after this.
Hurry, girls, before Daddy gets up.
Ooh, I'm ready.
And no more of these are Daddy's corn pops.
Oh, look, Daddy's bowl is too full.
The problem with a cereal that tastes like popcorn, only sweeter, is that it disappears like popcorn, only faster.
Mommy, that's Daddy.
Who's Cher?
Hi, girls.
Happy birthday!
Now let's all go make him breakfast.
Kellogg's Corn Pops. It's hard to stop when it's pop.
Where nature stores gas. Where man does. Right idea. Brighter idea.
True value. Help is just around the corner.
Christy Yamaguchi headlines the field at the Durasoft Colors World Challenge of Champions. Plus Olympic champ Tony Mo soars again next on ABC's Wide World of Sports.
Our entrepreneur friend, Nick Marmando, salute the champion's honoree this year. He was formerly the president of the National Bowling Hall of Fame. Long list.
Like Del Ballard, Nick with a long list of credits. Okay, now I bring in my man, Ren.
Thanks, Chris. And Mulatto, you haven't won since 1992, the fall of 1992, and I know you're hungry for victory.
I'm so hungry I can eat a rhino.
Bon appetit, amigo.
Chris, he's really getting robbed on that left-hand lane. But what's happening on the left-hand lane compared to the right is just before the ball's hitting the pins, it's stopping just a shade, enough to leave a ring in 10 instead of driving through like it is on lane 50. Steve Steve Wilson with a nine-pin lead can increase it to 19 right here, Chris. Mm-hmm. And really put the hammer in nice and early.
He uses about 7/8 of the approach.
Well, I guess you got to make room for the young folks, Johnny. You sure do, Chris. This is getting like wine. I mean, he's actually making better shots now than he did in the first game. Even though his score was a little bit lower in the second game, he threw it better than game one, and now he's throwing it better than game two.
Nerves and strength and lots of desire. Look at that. 22 of a possible 29. And we're sitting next to the king of the strikes, man that shot that perfect 300 game here on TV. And what fun it was, Johnny, to see you receive that check for $100,000.
Greatest moment of my life, Chris. And now Dell needs his. He backs off the approach and wants to be ready.
Spare up, six frame.
Nice shot. Watch Dell. He starts here. He's going to slide about 30 and send it out over 30 and way back. And now this ball will keep driving all the way. That's why he's not leaving ring and tens on this lane. I'm going to make a slight adjustment here.
Super. Now he's happier. Trailing now by 19, Dell Ballard against Steve Wilson. We're in Sayville, Long Island, the Edwards homestead, an historical landmark, has the distinction of being Sayville's first resident.
Continental Tires in a torture test. Advanced technology in high-performance tires. Conti Sport Contact. Continental General Tire. Quality tire manufacturer and sponsor of the PBA.
Oh, hey, Joe.
Hey, Joe.
Hey, Bob.
How's it going, man?
How's it going, man?
Great. Game's almost on. Got any Bud Light?
Hurry, I'm fresh out.
Fresh out! Fresh out!
Well, I'm out of here.
Hide the Bud Light! Joe's coming over! Hide the Bud Light!
Big Mouth, if you want great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Come on, where'd you hide the Bud Light?
It's in the garage! In the garage!
She was one of golf's greatest friends. Now the LPGA honors her memory in their first major of the year. The Nabisco Dinah Shore begins next Saturday on ABC.
We've returned to Leisure's Long Island Open in Sayville, South Shore, this beautiful spot, big part of America.
First crack in the armor there, Chris. Came out of commercial, got a little bit soft. Causing the ball to go high and leaving the 3-6 on the same lane that left the 3-6 in the first game.
He just joined us. And Samantha's 1-2, 256 to Billy Oaks, 173.
Chris, he switched to a ball that went straighter, and whether it was a bad shot or he forgot that it was going to hook less, it slid on him. Watch as he comes out of the ball, he thinks he's made it, but the ball continues to slide to the right, never grabbing the lane. Causing the ball not to come up, and he missed the spare. We have a whole new game right now. And with Dell Ballard on the bench, we got one tough guy to beat now.
This is Steve Wilson's third game of the afternoon. His second game is 246 to Bo Burton's 218. That four.
All right, Chris, the last two shots, he's finally pinched just a little bit and unfortunately paid the max in the previous frame. This was a solid four. Here's their replay. Pinches it just a little bit soft. Now see, high pocket, leaves the four pin. Whoops.
I think tempo, timing, maybe he's trying to bowl as fast as Del Ballard.
Oh, but Chris, when you're U.S. Open champion, Firestone champion, it's times like this. You're down six pins. You need a good shot.
Mm-hmm.
This is when you throw.
There's the proof of the pudding.
Right there, Chris. What the superstars do is more important the shot, the better they throw it. I love watching their eyes. They keep their eyes on that target. Their head never moves. That's when you got it for the butter.
Mm-hmm.
Big four. He's really upset.
God,
tried to soften up a little, not to leave that ringing pin again. He doesn't want that ball to leave a ringing pin. He gets a little soft and a little wider, trying to make it finish deep, and it goes right through the heart. He'll throw it hard at the 4-7.
This is a semifinal game. The winner will go into the final game.
That's
against Leto Monticelli.
That gives him a 13-pin lead for Steve Wilson as he steps up. Two marks, he could lock up the game with good wood.
Next week we'll be in the historic New England, where bowling's top stars take aim in a classic, the Thomas Classic. Next Saturday, 3 Eastern and Pacific, 2 Central. Here on ABC's Pro Bowlers Tour, and then the following week in Erie for the Spitfire Spark Plug Open. The finals to be contested on special lanes set up in the Erie Civic Center.
Strikers fair to win. Fast eight again, Chris. He's left a couple of four pins, and that's basically the same thing as a four pin that fast eight. Here's the same place as the four pin in the eighth frame. The head pin goes around the both of them this time. He has to make this spare and get eight pins on his fill ball to lock out Del Ballard. Watch it. Oh, now we have a 202 finish for Steve Wilson. Ballard needs 20 for a tie, 21 to win. If he goes strike, spare, or spare, strike, we have a tie. If he throws a double, he's a winner. He's on his good lane. Chris,
right.
I'm very embarrassed. I made a mistake. Steve Wilson finished with 203, and I added wrong, and I apologize. Del Ballard needs this strike to win. If he doesn't, he loses by one pin.
No problem.
Smack me in the mouth later.
No problem. Johnny Petraglia. You can see why we appreciate having him as a friend, not only himself, but his whole family. Goodness.
Bell's going to lose by one pin.
Get this, 203 to 202. Steve Wilson winning his third game. He goes into the finals. This ABC Sports presentation of Professional Bowlers Tour will continue after these messages. And a word from our ABC station.
I went from probably 300 miles on a full tank to almost 400.
America is talking about Spitfire.
I'm probably getting, I would say about 20 miles more. per tank full, and that's a lot for me.
And when you're driving a four-wheel drive vehicle, you need all the extra gas mileage you can get.
I have them on my motorcycle, my boat, and my car.
I love them.
Splitfire. At $5.99, it only costs more till you use it.
Okay, two scoops of raisins make Kellogg's Raisin Bran taste so good, people forget it's good for you. What do you think?
It's delicious.
And?
It tastes good.
That's the same reason.
It's all my answers.
And it's not an answer.
I agree with them. It tastes great.
Okay. You got the first part right. Kellogg's Raisin Bran tastes good, but...
Good for us!
There are two reasons to eat Kellogg's Raisin Bran. The taste.
And...
Tuesday in All New Blue.
I got the feeling lately that I'm being followed.
Yeah, no, I want to look into this.
Kelly has to protect his ex-wife.
It's a little upsetting to be a candidate to be murdered.
NYPD Blue, Tuesday here on ABC. Viewer discretion advised.
Eyewitness News has new information on this story.
Jason's.
The investigation is unfolding.
Freeland.
We're going live now to Channel 12 Logan Crawford.
Libet.
Eyewitness News has just learned.
Watch it.
We're going live to the
Channel 12 Eyewitness News. We're going all out for every story.
Underspend at Alfred's Furniture today, and with a minimum purchase, pay no money till January 1995. Hi, this is John. Today at Alfred's, have new furniture in your home with no money to pay until 1995. Your credit card company can't do it. Your bank can't do it. Only Alfred's with guaranteed lowest prices can do it. No down payments, no interest charges, no monthly payments till 1995, not until next year. It doesn't cost money to buy. At the store that sells more furniture than any store in Rhode Island, Alfred's, Route 6, Seekonk.
Putting an end to scandal, uncovering corruption, and shaking things up. He's doing the job no one else can. Target 12 investigative reporter Jack White.
Karen Adams, Channel 12, Eyewitness News.
I'm Julie Moran in New York. We'll return to bowling in just a moment. But coming up next on Wide World, Olympic figure skating gold medalist Christy Yamaguchi and longtime rival Midori Ito headlined the Duracell Colors World Challenge of Champions. Plus, Olympic gold medalist Tommy Moe in World Cup downhill skiing. And from the pages of Sports Illustrated, the issue of athletes and security. What price for fame? It's all coming up next on Wide World. Now let's go back to bowling.
...25-year-old Steve Wilson of Fort Lauderdale, Florida, impressive big scores in his first two victories, and then ekes out a one-pen victory over veteran Del Ballard Jr., and now finds another veteran to face for the championship. Johnny, it's been exciting thus far.
Oh, it is, and it's important to realize what Steve Wilson has done, because this goes back, including today, 27 games. He's been doing this the last 27 games to reach this point. Tremendous performance for him.
Occasionally we use the word amazing. And we have invited you over the past few weeks to send us in some amazing and funny videos. Well, here's an example of what we're receiving. I think you'll enjoy it. You may remember, a few weeks ago in Peoria, Brian Goble used this near-perfect form to win his third PGA title, defeating an amazed Norm Duke, who had 11 strikes. Yes, and still lost. Look at it. For even more amazement, we'll now take you across the Pacific to Japan. First, a normal strike attempt. Next, he puts load the rack up with 105 pins. And then, show you a few unusual strike attempts. The best shot of the day, 88 pins. So here's our address for your funny and unusual videos, bowling videos, and Sonia Station, Post Office Box 1800, New York, New York, 1023-1800. Okay. Championship game coming up. You've been in Japan?
Yes, I've been in Japan. That was terrific. That was just great.
So is this 25-year-old non-winner, Steve Wilson.
Chris, I think this first shot is going to be interesting after three four pins on this lane. I want to see if he adjusts in the first frame.
Good adjustment it was.
sure did.
Now here's Mr. Smoothie. Tomato.
The king of swing right here.
Back-to-back player of the year honors, 89 and 90.
Chris, here's Amuleto's form. Now watch, he walks to the left, and then his swing follows right behind his back. Now his swing will come down this way. That's what makes him feed the ball to the right. Great game. Perfect balance.
It's like boxing's counter puncher. Amuleto Monacelli.
Chris, he's ready. He is committed. He's been so upset about not winning last year. He wants one so bad he can taste it.
Three wins already today.
A solid 10 for Steve Wilson on a great shot. I'm not really sure, but I think this may be the first time that he's behind all day. We'll have to see how he performs from a negative position.
Sherry Holden, his fiancée. Smile.
Yeah, Sherry's a great person, Chris. It's a lot of fun.
And now a four.
Is that four pin again, Chris? 49. It's creeping up on him. He's got four pins or and a fast eight in the last five shots on that lane. He remembered in the first frame when the game started, but it got him again that time.
From Manhattan to Montauk. That's how we can describe Long Island, 118 miles, and it varies in width, 12 to 20. And this man is just as flexible and as solid. Amuleto Monacelli doubled up third frame.
A little wide, Chris, a half 10. It was a pretty good shot, and when you get to that half 10 spot, sometimes you get the scout, sometimes you don't. When he lets it go, he makes a real good shot. That inside out swing makes him feed it right. Here it is hooking back, but the head pin dies in the gutter. It doesn't really get out to come back and take the 10 out.
All right. Married to Teresa, architect of their new home, an interior decorator, while her sister, Angela, is the engineer at their new home in Barquisimeto, Venezuela.
They've been working on that home for over a year, Chris, and I hear it's spectacular. I guess he'll have to invite me to send a boat or something.
Amuleto Monacelli trying to break his jinx. We're in the final match. We'll be back.
A very expensive maker of lawn tractors likes to say, nothing runs like them. The makers of Yardman tractors take exception to that. The Yardman lawn tractor uses a powerful engine to mulch, bag, and side discharge, and it has a hydrostatic transmission. So it runs like a you-know-what, only it doesn't run for nearly as much money. Yardman. American-made, American-owned.
NAPA, we're the most complete source for auto parts, and all NAPA parts are backed by a nationwide warranty program. No wonder more Americans trust NAPA to keep their vehicles running.
Keep America running. It's never-
never fun to eat and run, to rush and eat too fast. Cause you know it's gonna catch up with you at last.
For acid indigestion or heartburn with headache, nothing's faster than Alka-Seltzer.
Get yourself some Alka-Seltzer and you'll feel better fast.
Get ready for the thunder down under. The new seats make nights when Indy cars take to the street. It's the Valvoline Australian Grand Prix Sunday on ABC.
Okay. All Long Island bowling is cool. It is today, but warming up. About 4 inches of snow yesterday here on this nearly 2,000 square miles, an area shaped like a fish. Native Americans call it the Pomonok. And here in Suffolk County, we saw another Steve Wilson strike in the fourth frame.
Well, he's wired on lane 50, Chris. He's making no mistakes there. Actually, the only mistakes he's making are, I think, switching balls when he's shooting spares, and he's gone back to using his strike ball for spares, which would be a lot better off.
32-year-old, Leto Monacelli.
To try and tie the match, Chris. Mm-hmm. In the lane with all the fourth ones.
Tripped and gone. Okay.
Great shot there.
Game is on.
It's an even game again, Chris. Amleto would have to strike to retake the lead.
Here's a man that has lost his last six television matches. He hasn't won one since November 11th, 1992.
Well, just like Steve Wilson's, the solid eight on lane 50. You can't throw the ball any better than this. Watch the ball drive through, chop the five straight off the eight and go straight back. That ball's supposed to deflect a little bit, Chris, and the five go into the eight.
This year he's had a sixth place and a third place finish, all coming in the past 3 weeks.
And what a critical time for the solid eight. When Wilson doubles and is getting back up on his good lane, your brain starts to say, well, now I can fall behind 10 pins fairly early in the game, and you don't want that to happen.
Mm-hmm.
Now watch, Amleto's going to start here and walk in this direction. The swing will follow him, and then he will feed the ball out this way toward the second arrow.
Six frame strike from Leto Monacelli. This is the championship game. 24,000 to the winner.
Steve Wilson for the lead.
This young man going for his first PBA national title.
Well, what can you say, Chris? I mean, for your first PBA title, to throw it that good and leave a solid 10, exactly like the one you left in the second frame. He is switching balls for the 10 pin.
Teresa on the left, Monacelli. Sherry Holden, Steve's fiance.
Is that enough tension there, Chris? It's so tough to bowl when you're watching and you can't do anything about it.
Your wife, Pat, was watching you as you rolled a 300.
Well, he's made the adjustment on lane 49. The four pins are gone. Back-to-back ring and tens. Chris, what can I say? You can't throw it any better. Nobody's losing this match. Somebody's just bowling a higher score.
Championship battle continues with the tournament leader.
Try to increase his lead to 12 pins with the strike here. Oh, Chris, he threw that ball so well. That time, the ball hit the A pin.
Okay.
Such a powerful bowling ball that nothing could stand up on shots like that.
One of the 12, or the 11 millionaires, Professional Bowlers Association. Let him on the challenge. We look at Steve, the man he eliminated in the previous match, even though he lost it, became the 11th millionaire, Del Ballard Jr. Congratulate him. Money earned.
A solid four on 49. It jumped up and bit Amuleto too. It's a crucial position. However, he does have an 11-pin lead if he converts the spare. This lane's jumping just a little bit more. It looks like it's solid. Looks like it's solid. Last 2 feet, just high pocket to leave the solid four. Spare would give him an 11-pin lead.
And Leto with 13 PBA titles in his 12-year career.
Now Steve Wilson's left back-to-back 10 pins. There's been 11 10 pins left today, half ones or ringing ones, and the carry is the most important thing right now.
Here's a young man that has a fiance of a friend that sponsors him out here on the tour, Tara McCoy.
Oh,
I like that.
Well, Chris, here's the critical ninth. Here is maybe the whole tournament. Steve Wilson can strike out for 237, and Leto can strike out for 238. But if Steve Wilson doesn't strike here, Amuleto could go strike, spare, strike, and lock him out.
The scout missed the 10.
It had blinders on. It was a real good shot. Good trust on the lane where the four pins go. See, he trusted it on this lane because he knows it's jumping for a four pin. Great shot. Swishes the five. Here comes the head pin. But it just doesn't get the 10 right in front of him.
Well, that time the green bowling ball didn't let him down.
Oh, no. He's been making spares all game.
Mm-hmm.
Now Amuleto has his own destiny in his hands. It's all up to him. If he strikes here and goes spare strike in the 10th, or spare 9 now, spare strike in the 10th, he'd lock him out by a pin, Chris.
Okay.
Chris, that ball hit too hard. That ball not only went into the 8 pin, it went into the 8 pin so far it missed the 9 pin. When Bo talked earlier about pins getting heavier and what mm-hmm. we're looking into, there's the reason right there. Look at how hard this ball hits. No deflection at all. It goes right by the 9 pin.
So you vote for heavier pins?
Well, at the pro level, I do, yes.
Yes.
Now, Chris, as we get up in the 10th, it's a 10-pin game. Amuleto doubles in the 10th, he's the winner. If he throws the first strike in the 10th and then gets a spare, Steve Wilson could throw 3 strikes to tie. Anything less than that, he could lose the tournament.
Johnny Petraglia sitting in as Nelson Burton Jr. made the final 5 today and lost his match, but bowled beautifully. Now,
Chris, you don't get to be bowler of the year twice, making bad shots when you need it. One of his best shots at the game. Great trust. That 6-pin jumps out, slaps the 10 out when you had to do it. The strike for the win. If he spares, there's a possible tie situation. Bring in 10. He actually threw that ball better than the last one. If he makes the spare, he has a lock tie. Steve Wilson would have to get up and get 3 strikes to tie the match. Boy, this is a great finish.
Well, John, you came in the right day. You're having fun, aren't you?
Well, you need drama. You got it.
Well, you provided the most drama. We've had 300.
Now here's Steve Wilson, 27 games in 9 frames. He's performed beautifully. Can he throw the last 3 to send it into sudden death?
Look at that. He's won. Bud Poise, 25 years old. He has 3 victories. Not the least bit tired.
No losers in this match, Chris. Only winners.
Of course, this man seeking his very first that would put him into the General Tire Tournament of Champions of victory here today, John.
Boy, Chris, he really trusted that one and got it all. Great shot there. Threw both balls, both high flush in the pocket. It comes down to one shot. It's just, this is as good as it gets. I'm just on pins and needles here.
Okay. Better than 1,000 words right now.
Shreds the rack when he has to. Tremendous performance.
Now a 2-frame roll-up. See the tension on that 13-time champion, Amleta Monacelli, trying to break that jinx in his brilliant pro career, tied by a non-winner at 217. Johnny?
What a terrific last shot. Trusted it wide and it carried. Here we go. Sudden death. Solid 10 again, Chris.
Mm-hmm.
He could be snake, but that's about his worst shot of the day.
Sure.
Can't throw him any better than that.
Frame roll-off after a 217 tie. If you're just joining us, this man has gone through 3 pros now against Amleta.
One. Now he controls his own destiny, Chris. 2 more strikes and then keep it on the lane and stay behind the foul line. And he's the Long Island Open champion.
Amleta. Not won a TV game since November 11th, 1992.
Well, it's not because of his performance,
no.
That's for sure. He's just been a little bit unlucky. Oh! Chris, great trust. 5 pin slaps into the 4 pin and stands up. A really bad break. He's trusting it on that lane where he knows he can leave the 4 pin. Here comes the ball. Watch. 5. It's nicked. Doesn't even get to the 4 pin. We have a possibility of another tie, Chris. If he strikes on the fill ball, Monticelli would need a double. If he gets 9, Monticelli would need strikes spare.
Appreciating this match with us today is our senior vice president, Dennis Moon, and his wife, Vicki. They know how to pick the spots for action.
Doors open, half 10. Amleta, 9 spare strike for a tie, strike spare for a win.
Steve Wilson.
Trust is a must. Or your game is the bus, is the old expression.
Mm-hmm.
Amleto trusted to the right. Extra lift with the fingers. That ball just hit like a train. Now he needs a spare. A strike or a spare on this ball. He strikes on this ball, he's a winner. If he makes a spare, he's a winner.
24 to the winner, 13 to the runner-up. And that's, there is no loser today. Runner-up.
Whoops. First bad shot of the day, Chris. He got lucky. He left only the 3-6. If he gets one of them, we have another tie. If he gets both of them, Monticelli wins the tournament. He threw it bad, Chris.
Mm-hmm.
Went through the nose. He had the 3-6, 9-10 for a second, but ended up with only the 3-6. He needs the both of them to win.
A winner, a 1-10 victory in overtime. 40-39 after a 2-17 time. Monticelli, 14th PBA title. Steve Wilson, a great job.
12%.
Plus a couple hundred dollars in fees.
But you know, then, that was a good rate.
Yeah, it was good.